Hello, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's topic, we are continuing with our laws of motion. Okay, in last videos and all, we were doing the numericals based on this chapter, isn't it? So today also we are continuing with that one. So in last class, we finished till the 16th question, isn't it? So today we are starting with the 17th one from page number 111. 17th one. Okay. A nucleus is at rest in the laboratory frame of reference. Show that if it disintegrates into two smaller nuclei, the products must move in the opposite directions. A nuclei is at rest. Show that it disintegrates into smaller nuclei. Okay, so they will be moving in the opposite direction, like that we should show, isn't it? Initially the molecule was at rest. So this nucleus was at rest, M1 and M2. The disintegrated nucleus are at rest at that time, isn't it? M1 and M2 are at rest. After collision, after disintegration, what will happen? Both are moving with, after disintegration, M1 and M2 are moving with velocities, V1 and V2 moving with velocities V1 and V2, like that we can consider. Okay, so here how we can find out, one is moving the it's in opposite direction to the other, like that only we should show, isn't it? Show that if it disintegrates into two smaller nuclei, the products must move in the two opposite directions. How we can find out? Here also we can apply the law of conservation of momentum. Law of conservation of momentum states that M1 U1 plus M2 U2 will be equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. Initially they were at rest, therefore U1 and U2 will be 0. That will be equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. So if I am finding out the value of V1, what I will be getting? Minus M2 V2 divided by M1. So M1 and M2 doesn't have any direction. So V1 is proportional to minus V2 for a particular nuclei. Like that we will get. What is the meaning of that? V1 is opposite to the direction of V2. So V1 is in the opposite direction. Like that we will get. Clear? So the next is 18th one. 2 billiard balls, each of mass 0.05 kilogram, moving in opposite directions with speed 6 meter per second, collide and rebound with the same speed. Okay, what is the what we should find out? Impulse imparted to each ball due to the other. That one we should find out. Okay, so how we can find out the impulse? So what are the datas given? First we will look into that. 2 billiards balls, each of mass M1 and M2 are of same mass, isn't it? 0.05 kilogram. Each of mass 0.05 kilogram, moving in opposite directions with the speed 6 meter per second. So moving in opposite directions with the 6 meter per second and rebound with the same speed. So they are moving in opposite direction with the same speed. So U1 is equal to 6 meter per second and U2 is equal to minus 6 meter per second. What is the impulse imparted to each ball due to the other? Okay, so we should find out, and after collision, what will, after collision they rebound with the same speed. Rebounding means, so V1 will be equal to minus 6 meter per second and V2 will be equal to plus 6 meter per second. Impulse we should find out. Impulse, how we can find out the impulse? Force into time, F into T, isn't it? What is F in this time? As what is meant by impulse? A large force acting for a small interval of time. That is called a impulsive force. If del, since it is small interval of time, I am writing it as delta t. So what is this F into delta t? As per Newton's second law, F is equal to k into dp by dt. So what is F into dp by dt? F into dt, that is dp, that is equal to change in momentum. So impulse directly you can write it as change in momentum. Okay, so what is the change in momentum over here? So m1 final momentum minus initial momentum. Initial momentum. Okay, what is the final momentum? M1 V1 minus M1 U1. Okay, so what is the final momentum? 0.05 into minus 6 minus M1 into 6. Isn't it? So how much you will be getting? So 0.05 is common. So minus 6 minus 6. So it is minus 12. So here 0.05 into minus 12. So you will get it as 6.6. What is the unit of impulse? Newton second. Newton second. Or you can write it as kilogram meter per second also you can write out. Okay. So understood how we are finding out this value. So the next one is 19th one. A shell of mass 0.02 kilogram is fired by a gun of mass 100 kilogram. If the muzzle speed of the shell is 80 meter per second, what is the recoil speed of the gun? Okay, so listen here. Mass of shell 0.02 kilogram is fired by a mass of gun. Mass of gun is 100 kilogram. If the muzzle speed of the shell is, speed of the muzzle speed means the, it is moving with the speed of. So velocity of the speed will be, the shell will be equal to 80 meter per second. What is the recoil speed of the gun? Initially, in last video also we did the same kind of problem. Are you remembering? So so initially bullet as well as the gun will be in the same at rest, isn't it? After when we are shooting that one, what will happen? Speed will be, velocity of the shell will be moving with the muscle speed means the movement. While moving, what is the velocity? That is 80 meter per second. Now we should find out the recoil velocity of the gun. How we can find out this one? So here also conservation of momentum, ms us plus mg ug will be equal to ms vs plus mg vg. So initially since they are at rest, that will be equal to 0. 0 will be equal to ms vs plus mg vg. Okay, so from here Vg we can find it out as minus MSVS. MSVS we are taking to the left side, so it will become minus MS divided by Mg. So what is minus MS? You can substitute the values 0.02 80 divided by 100 kilogram. Okay, so we will get it as 1.6 divided by 100. So the answer will be 0.016 meter per second. This will be the recoil velocity of the gun. Clear? Next is 20th question. A batsman deflects a ball by an angle of 45 degree without changing its initial speed, which is equal to 54 kilometer per hour. What is the impulse imparted to the ball? Okay, so A batsman deflects a ball by an angle of 45 degree without changing its initial speed, which is equal to 54 kilometer per hour. So initial speed is equal to 54 kilometer per hour, and final speed also will be equal to 54 kilometer per hour. Okay, so what we should find out, what is the impulse imparted? Mass of the ball is given as 0.015 kilogram. We should find out the impulse. Impulse, how we can find out? You will think it is very easy. Change in momentum, mv minus mu. So what we will be getting? But here, how we will be finding out? It's making an angle 45 degree. Suppose if this is the position of the ball, bat. Ball is coming here, incidenting and reflecting back. Okay, so this is making an angle 45 degree. So velocity is coming with an angle, isn't it? So how we can find out? So this is initial velocity, final velocity also same only u. Isn't it? It's going with the same velocity backward direction, so it is also u. So if this is the normal which is acting, this is the normal which is acting. So this will be 45 by 2, isn't it? This also 45 by 2. So these two are vectors. These two vectors, I am dividing it into components. So this is, if this is theta, what will be this value? This is u. This will be u cos theta and this will be u sin theta. And this is theta. If we are making this angle as theta, what we will be getting? If this is theta, this one we will get it as u cos theta and this will be u sin theta. Okay, so here while we are considering the incident, point of incidence while we are considering. See here, if I am taking this as O and this is OA and this is OB and this is OC. Okay, while I am considering the incidence, okay, when it is coming towards the point, what will happen? U is dividing it into U cos theta along OB and U sin theta along OA. Okay, along OA. So U is dividing into U cos theta and U sin theta. U cos theta and U sin theta. Now we are considering this one. So here it is again U cos theta and U sin theta. Okay, so here while we are considering the reflection or rebounding, while we are considering the while going back, what are the directions? U cos theta will be acting along OC and U sin theta is again acting along OA. Isn't it? So we can see U sin theta along OA, U sin theta along OA. Both are in the same direction without any change. Isn't it? There is no change here. So then change in momentum will be there? No. Because of horizontal direction, we won't be getting any change in momentum. So velocity is not changing. Velocity, direction and magnitude, all everything is same. So it's not changing. Now what we should do? We should find out the vertical direction. So while finding out the vertical direction, what we will be getting? Vertical direction means u will be u cos theta in one direction and u sin theta, u cos theta in the opposite direction, isn't it? So if I am upward direction, if I am taking it as positive, downward direction I can take it as negative. Any one direction, if downward I am taking it as positive, upward I can take it as negative. Any one. Okay, so change in momentum, how we can find out change in momentum? Final momentum minus initial momentum. Final momentum is u cos theta minus u cos theta into m. So we will be getting 2m u cos theta. Mass of the object is given, mass of the ball is given, u is given as 54. So 54 kilometer per hour, you can convert it into meter per second, 5 by 18. So it will be 15 meter per second. So here you can write it as 2 into ms 0.015, and this is 15, and cos theta, what is theta? 45/2. Okay, that is theta. So you can find out the value using this. Clear now how we are finding out the change in momentum? So usually we will be while taking the vectors in the same direction, we will add up. Here we are taking the difference, because change in momentum only we need, isn't it? That is the reason. Clear for you? Next one is 21st. A stone of mass 0.25 kilogram tied to the end of a string is whirled round in a circle of radius 1.5 meter with a speed of 40 revolutions per minute in a horizontal plane. What is the tension in the string? What is the maximum speed with which the stone can be whirled round if the string can withstand a maximum tension of 200 Newton. So mass of the stone is given as 0.25 kilogram. Tied to the end of a string is whirled round in a circle of radius 1.5 meter. So the radius is given as 1.5 meter. With a speed of 40 revolutions per minute in a horizontal plane. So number of revolutions is 40 revolutions in per minute. Okay, that is n is given. What is the tension in this string? How we can find out the tension? If n is given, we can find out the omega value. How we can find out the omega value? If omega is the angular velocity. Angular velocity means distance traveled divided by time. Isn't it? So how much will be the distance traveled for one circular revolution? What will be the distance traveled? 2 pi divided by t. Time. Isn't it? So what will be the time taken for 40 revolutions in 1 second? 40 revolutions in 1 second means 40 by 60 we should take, isn't it? So we will be considering it as 2 into pi into 2 divided by 3. So omega we are getting it as 2 pi into 2 pi by 3. That is omega value, 4 pi by 3. Okay, so we will be getting it as T. How we can tension, how we can find out what is the tension value? M R omega square. M already got it as 0.25, R is 1.5, omega is 4 pi by 3 the whole square. Okay, so now while solving it, you can find out the tension in the string. Okay, clear, easy, right? So here you should understand only these things. Okay, number of revolutions per minute is given. So you can find out the number of revolutions per second and convert it into omega, 2 pi by t. So 2 pi by t into 40 by 60, t means we know it has time period for 1 second, isn't it? So 2 pi into 2 by 3 we got it. So it is 40 by 3, 4 pi by 3. Next is, along with that, one more question is there, right? What is the maximum speed with which the stone can be whirled round if the string can withstand a maximum tension of 200 Newton? So maximum tension is equal to 200 Newton. If the maximum tension is 200 Newton, what is the maximum speed? So how we can find out the maximum speed while it is moving with a particular velocity? What will be the T max equals mv square by r, a force which is acting, or tension acting, will be equal to the centripetal force, mv square by r. So we can find out v max as r into T max divided by m under root. Okay, so we can write it as R is 1.5, T max is given as 200 Newton divided by M is 0.25 kilogram. While solving this, you will get the answer. Clear? Next, we are doing the 23rd one. A hose cannot pull a cart and run in empty space. What is the reason? Tell me. In a hose and cart problem, that is actually an interesting idea. So this is a cart and this is the position of hose. This is hose and this is cart. W is acting downwards and a reactional force is acting like this. For the cart, a frictional force will be acting in this direction. Okay, and the same way for this hose also, one W will be acting in this direction and a reactional force of the hose will be acting in this direction. But whether the reactional force is acting in the exactly opposite direction? No, because hose is not standing, it is pulling the cart, isn't it? While it is pulling the cart, this reactional force will be acting in this direction, which will be making an angle theta. This will be the reactional force. So here, this will be, if this is theta, this also will be theta. Then this is RH sine theta and this will be RH cos theta. Isn't it? So here, WH will be balancing with the RH sine theta. WC will be balancing with the RC. Isn't it? So here, what is the other? So if F is less than RH cos theta, that is, if RH cos theta is greater than F, then only it can pull the cart. So it can pull the cart if F is less than RH cos theta. In empty space, whether the reactional force can be applicable over there, it's not applicable. That is the reason we can't, the hose can't pull the cart in an empty space. Okay. So the next one is, passengers are thrown forward from their seats when a speeding bus stops suddenly. What will happen when a speeding bus, when the bus is in motion, the passengers will be having the inertia of motion, isn't it? So if the passengers are at inertia of motion, so they have the tendency to continue in its motion, isn't it? But when it is suddenly stopping, the lower part will come to rest position, but the upper part of the body will be still continuing with its motion, inertia of motion. Because of that reason only, the passengers will be moving forward. Okay. So the next one, see, it is easier to pull a lawn mower than to push. So easier is pulling. Pulling is easier. So this is the point. Okay, if it is pulling. Pulling means it will be applying force like this, isn't it? What will happen? See here, if we are applying a reactional force in this manner, what will happen? R cos theta and this will be R sine theta. Okay, so the frictional force, this frictional force will be acting in this direction and R cos theta is in the opposite direction it is acting, isn't it? So R cos theta is greater than this one. It will work. Okay, mg will be balancing with this one. Now while pushing, what will happen? See, while we are pushing the lawn roller, what will happen? R cos theta, this will be R cos theta and this will be R sine theta. You see what will happen? This R cos theta is going along the direction of friction. So what will happen? We should apply more work to do F plus R cos theta. Instead of that, here means R cos theta is supporting this, opposing the frictional force. But here R cos theta is moving along the friction. So it will be easy. Which will be easy? Then pulling will be easier. Okay. So the next one is, a cricketer moves his hand backwards while holding a catch. What will happen? Suddenly the ball will be coming to rest. If we are he is not moving his hand, suddenly the ball will be coming to rest. If suddenly if it is at rest, what will happen? The impulse will be more. If impulse F into delta T, isn't it? So the impulse after effect will be more. So if he is moving his hand like this, what will happen? Yes, velocity is slowly coming to rest. It's not at a sudden velocity change. Velocity, if it is coming with a higher velocity and velocity is suddenly becoming zero, this change is very, very much, isn't it? So it will be pain, after effect will be more. But if velocity is decreasing continuously and coming to rest position, means that much of pain won't be there in the hand. That is the reason. Okay, clear? So, understood all of you? I hope all of you understood all those things. And if you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye.